In 2007, the Writers Guild of America went on strike for 100 days.
And so what I'm trying to say is this could be your last look at me and Paul.
Because if we can break 41, it's going to be pretty exciting. You ready to go, Max?
Yeah! And I realize that some writers may be upset because they think I'm making fun of the strike. But if you are a writer and you can't recognize irony...
This strike ended with them getting a contract that ensured the writers a stake in the revenue generated when their movies, television shows, and other creative works got distributed on the internet. But the internet evolves fast, and this deal is already out of date. So the writers are on strike again, but this time it could last a lot longer than 100 days. We recently just saw the $188 million television series Metropolis get cancelled, which was supposed to film 3 seasons in Australia. One of the biggest factors in this cancellation was that the final shooting scripts were not ready by the time the strike began. So why are the writers on strike, and why is this affecting the rest of the world? The Writers Guild of America is a labor union that represents over 11,000 writers of film and TV. It negotiates on behalf of the writers to the AMPTP, which is the Alliance of Motion Picture and Television Producers, which represents all the major motion picture and television studios, including Sony Pictures, Universal Studios, Paramount Pictures, Warner Brothers, Walt Disney Studios, ABC, NBC, CBS, Netflix, Apple TV, and Prime Video. Contracts between the two get negotiated every 3 years, and unfortunately this year they couldn't come to an agreement. So, what are the writers asking for?
We have to get paid fairly to be able to produce good TV.
It's the streaming era that has really changed the landscape of writers' jobs and how they are employed by production companies. One thing that is more common now is shorter seasons. Where shows would usually have 22 episode long series, they now have 6 to 12, meaning these writers are having to find 2 or 3 jobs in order to make the same amount of money they would have from working one 22 episode job. This also means it is significantly more difficult to get promoted. On longer running shows, writers were able to work their way up the ranks, but on shorter series, this is much less likely to happen.
We are going to stay out here and withhold our labor until the existence of the writers' room is codified into our contract.
Another change has been the introduction of the mini room. Instead of staffing a writer's room to write, let's say, 10 episodes for 12 to 22 weeks, in which part of this time is being on set to change dialogue and write ADR when needed, writers now only get 8 to 10 weeks in a mini room before production starts to map out the whole season. Then they hand the scripts off and their job is over. They don't get to go on set, and there is the constant risk that their work will never see the light of day. Being on set is extremely important, not only from a script perspective, but also when it comes to training writers to become showrunners. Mike Schur has discussed how being on set while he was a writer on The Office helped him to learn skills such as set design, working with actors, and sound mixing that helped him create The Good Place and Parks and Recreation. Not having writers be on set could be seen as a potential side effect from COVID, where regulations were brought in to limit the amount of people on set. But now things need to return. The AMPTP's response to this, however, was that they would consider instituting a lottery-based unpaid internship program. The AMPTP's perspective is that writers want to be kept on staff and paid when there is no work for them. Another change due to streaming is the lack of residuals. It used to be that writers would earn money when their shows were rerun. It was possible for writers to live off of the residuals for one script, especially if it was a popular show such as The Big Bang Theory or Friends. Now writers no longer get residuals, and one of the WGA's asks is for streaming sites to be less opaque with their numbers so that if a show does well, the writers can share in this success. And when it comes to AI, instead of preventing the use of AI to replace writers' jobs, the AMPTP only agreed to meet annually to discuss the use of AI. In the end, because these streaming sites don't need content to fill the air like broadcast does, they don't need shows urgently. Therefore, this strike could last a lot longer than it already has.
Hulu, Amazon, and Apple came into our industry. The studios exploited the changing landscapes of our business to increase their profits at the expense of our livelihoods. Yeah, Boo is right.
The AMPTP is standing by their statement that it's not the best time to increase wages. and production companies such as Disney, Warner Brothers, and Paramount are all laying off employees. If any writer not in the WGA, such as Australian writers, want to one day work in America, it'll serve in their best interest not to take any of these WGA jobs right now. So if this strike goes on for a lot longer and we don't have any writers writing television shows or movie scripts, then what we might see happen is we get a lot more reality television on our TV screens or YouTube content on our computers.